This is what Jesus said about marriage in Matthew chapter 19, verses 8 and 9. He said unto them, Moses, because of the hardness of your hearts, suffered you to put away your wives. But from the beginning it was not so. And I say unto you, whoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committeth adultery. And whoso marrieth her which is put away, do commit adultery. There is a clear distinction between fornication, which is primarital sexual intercourse, and adultery, which is marriage infidelity. I want to show you an example of this distinction and what Jesus meant when he said, whoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committed adultery. Especially because Jesus said, from the beginning it was not so. I read in Deuteronomy chapter 22, verses 13 to 19. If any man takes a wife and goes into her and detests her and charges her with shameful conduct and brings a bad name on her and says, I took this woman, and when I came to her, I found she was not a virgin. Then the father and mother of the young woman shall take and bring out the evidence of the young woman's virginity to the elders of the city at the gate. And the young woman's father shall say to the elders, I gave my daughter to this man as wife, and he detests her. Now he has charged her with shameful conduct, saying, I found your daughter was not a virgin. And yet, these are the evidences of my daughter's virginity. And they shall spread the cloth before the elders of the city. Then the elders of the city shall take that man and punish him. And they shall fine him 100 shekels of silver and give them to the father of the young woman, because he has brought a bad name on a virgin of Israel, and she shall be his wife. He cannot divorce her all his days. This man, even though he hated his wife, that was not a reason to divorce her, like many people do today. Today people divorce from thousands of reasons, but from the beginning it was not so. And God said he cannot divorce her all his days. Because once virginity was proven, there cannot be any other reason to divorce, not even marriage infidelity. And even the reason of fornication is nullified if you knew your wife or husband were not virgin and you accepted them as wife and husband, because the two become one until death sets them apart. The marriage bed used to be pure, and it's the way it should be, but many young people say this is too difficult and they want to experiment before they get married and get to know their partners intimately before they get married to them. Unfortunately, many single moms and single fathers said the same. Many young girls who had to abort their own children because they just had some fun, or because they let themselves be persuaded by reckless guys, said the same. God hates abortion. This is the way of this world. Can you see it? The world permits you to do as you please, even though this is hurting you. God is not like that. God cares for us, and he knows in advance what will hurt us, and he wants to protect us. As Christians, we must be light in the world. But if we become like the world, then it means the world is darkness for us. We must be an example for the world, not let the world overcome us. Same-gender marriage is an abomination to God. But Christians today don't care about what God cares, they care about what the world cares. Jesus encouraged us to overcome this world and its deceptions, but most Christians embrace it. Remarriage is adultery. It's not me saying it, but Jesus. And fornicators and adulterers will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. I read in Revelation chapter 21, verses 7 and 8. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the cowardly, unbelieving, abominable, murderers, sexually immoral, sorcerers, idolaters, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burns with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. May Jesus bless you.